In this video, I'll cover creating a flared roof using this section view as a guide. Let's look at how to use the CAD tools to create the template and then adjust the roof to follow. In this section view, I've drawn an arc with a 96-inch radius as a template to create the roof flare. On the outside of the wall, I've drawn a CAD line. It goes up to the top of the framing, just below the sheathing, which in Chief Architect is known as the roof baseline. In 2 feet from this line is the point where I want the flare to begin. The roof in Chief Architect builds out to the edge of the fascia. That is 1.5 feet beyond the outside of the wall. I've drawn the arc that spans between those 2 points and set the radius at 96 inches. It's approximately a 30-degree angle. Let's slide over to the other side of the house and repeat this process, and then I'll go through the steps to adjust the roof to follow. As I zoom in, first thing I'm going to do is select the line tool, and I'm going to come onto the outside of the framing layer, and I'm going to draw up till I snap just below the sheathing, which is in Chief Architect known as the roof baseline. I'm going to take this line, I'm going to make a copy of it, I'm going to slide it over. As I'm sliding it, I'm going to press the tab key, and I'm going to enter in 24 inches. I'm going to extend this line up just below the sheathing, and that will be the beginning of where I want the flare to start. One more line on the outside of the fascia will just show you where the roof is built in Chief Architect. The next thing I'm going to do is draw an arc between the start point and the end point. Before I do this, underneath the Edit menu, I'm going to come down to the arc creation modes. I'm going to make sure that I'm using the mode to start tangent for end of arc. Using the arc tool, I'm going to snap onto the upper line. I'm going to click and drag to the bottom where the roof will end its build, release the mouse, and I'm going to come up slope to generate the arc. Then I will left click. Now I'm going to double click on the arc. In the arc specification panel, there is a radius setting. I'm going to set that to be 96 inches. Notice that the lock point is at the start. I do have my start and end indicators on, so I will be locking the start point. The radius will be at 96 inches. Also note that the start direction, the roof is at 45 degrees since we're on the opposite side. It's a minus 135 degrees. At the bottom of the dialog, notice that the chord angle is at minus 150. That's going to work out to be a 30-degree slope that I want to use for the roof flare when I begin adjusting the roofs. Let me go ahead and tile my views underneath the window. You'll also find that you can tile using Shift F6. In the roof plan view on the left-hand side of the screen, this is going to require 2 unique roof planes. I'm going to make a copy of the first roof plane, adjust it, and I'm going to flare the second one. Let's begin by making a copy of this roof plane using the copy and paste in place. You'll see the paste hold position, and this created an exact copy of the existing roof plane in the same coordinates. I'm going to take this roof plane, you see the red selected handle, I'm going to snap it to the outside of the wall. I'm going to then slide it up. As I'm sliding it up, before I release, I'm going to press the tab key, and I'm going to move that exactly 24 inches. That will match this line right in here for that roof plane location. I'm going to take the other roof plane and go ahead and pull it back and so that it snaps right in that area. As I zoom in very closely, you can see that here is that roof intersection joint. Now for the lower roof section, let's go ahead and double click on it, open it up. On the general panel, the first thing I'm going to do is lock the ridge top height. I'm also displaying the roof in degrees. You can toggle this on with a checkbox directly below it. Notice that the roof pitch is using 45 degrees. I'm going to change the 45 to the 30 degrees that we got out of the arc when we drew that, and go ahead and close this dialog. So you can see in the section view, right at the pivot point, we've adjusted the roof. It's now a straight roof plane. The next thing I'm going to do, double click on the roof. Toward the bottom is the curved roof option. I'm going to make sure that I've locked the ridge top height. I'm going to come in at the ridge, and I'm going to change that to match the 45-degree angle that is at the upper roof pitch, which is at 12 and 12. The other thing I like to do with these curved roofs, The facet angle is at 7.5 degrees. It's currently using the automatic. I like to make this very smooth, and I'm going to change it to 1 degree. You can see that we've now flared the eave. You might notice on the flare that my original arc line goes out past the fascia. If I trim that back to the fascia, I'll just select the outside line, use my trim tool and trim this off, and then go back into the line. Notice that my chord angle is a larger decimal number. I'm just going to copy that, cancel out of the dialog. I'm going to go back into the roof panel. Be sure to lock the ridge top height, come down to the degrees for pitch, paste in the decimal. That adjusts the roof to be more in line with the arc with respect to the start and end points. That wraps up this video on flared roofs. To learn more, please see the built-in help file as well as our other videos. Thanks for watching.